3. The noun case or usage of noun. In grammar, case is the form of noun that shows its relationship with another word in the sentence. Noun serves various functions in the sentence. There are 6 kinds of cases in English grammar. First, nominative case. Second, objective case. Third, possessive case. Fourth, dative case. 5, ablative case. And 6th, occative case. But out of these 3 cases, only 3 cases are more important. Nominative case, objective case and possessive case. These we mostly use while writing and speaking in English. So let's see the case 1. Example number 1. Monica reads a book. Here Monica is noun. And this noun is functioning as subject. Monica is the subject of verb read. Who reads? Monica reads. So noun is functioning as a subject in the sentence. And when noun is functioning as a subject in the sentence, it is called subjective case or nominative case. Number 2. Hari broke the window. In this sentence, window is a noun. And in this sentence, this word is functioning as object. Let's see how is it object. What was broken? Its answer is window was broken. So in this subject, window is functioning as object of the verb. So it is in objective case. It is working here as an object. So this noun is as object here in the sentence. Now let's see third example. That is Rama's book. Here Rama is noun, but this noun is functioning to show the possession of book. So this Rama is noun, but it is showing the possession of book. So it is in possessive case. So we learn here with the help of these 3 examples that noun can function as subject, noun can function as object, noun can function as possessive, which shows the possession of thing. It shows the ownership of subjective case or nominative case. When a noun is used as the subject of verb, it is said to be in the nominative case or subjective case. When noun is functioning as the subject of verb in the sentence, then it is called that noun is in nominative case or subjective case. For example, Kedar is playing on the ground. Who is playing? Kedar. So Kedar is here in the subjective case or nominative case. Subjective case is also called as nominative case. Number 2. Ankita watches YouTube. Who watches YouTube? Ankita. So Ankita is here in subjective case. Number 2. Objective case. When a noun is used as the object of a verb, it is said to be in the objective case. It means when noun is functioning as an object of verb in the sentence, it is in objective case. For example, Rajesh saw a movie. What saw Rajesh? Its answer is a movie. Movie is a noun, but it is functioning here as an object. So it is here in objective case. Number 2. Ganesh made a mistake. Mistake is noun. This noun is functioning as an object of the verb made. What made Ganesh? Its answer is a mistake. So this noun is in objective case. Number 3. Possessive case. The meaning of the word possessive is showing the ownership of something. In this case, we notice possession or ownership with the form of noun. It means when noun is showing the possession of one thing or item, then we say that noun is in possessive case. For example, I took Meena's umbrella. Here, apostrophe is showing possession of Meena. Meena's. Meena is noun, but apostrophe shows the possession of umbrella. Meena's umbrella. Whose umbrella? Meena's. So, Meena is here in possessive case. When possession is shown, we use apostrophe. Number two, we went in the Sita's birthday party. Here, noun Sita is in possession because we have attached yes with apostrophe. So, Sita's is a noun and it is in possessive case. Usages of nouns or functions of nouns. Nouns are used as subject of verb. Nouns are used as an object of verb. Nouns are used in genitive case to show its possession as a noun. Nouns are used as subject complement. Nouns are used as object complement, or nouns are used as nouns in opposition. Let's see it one by one. Noun usages. Subject. We know nouns are used as subject. We have seen it in the subjective case. Number two, object. Nouns are used as object of verb. We also have learned it in the objective case. Number three, possessive case. This part also we have learned just before in possessive case. Number four, complement, subject complement. Complement is a word or phrase especially used after linking verbs such as be and become and describes the subject of verb. This complement is just describing to the subject or to the main subject in the sentence. For example, he is a doctor. In this sentence, word he is a pronoun and it is functioning as a subject in the sentence. A word doctor is a noun and this word is functioning as a subject complement because he and a doctor are not two different persons. This word is describing two subject, so it is called as subject complement. Second sentence, they are children. In this sentence, word they is a pronoun. It is functioning as a subject and the word children is a noun. And this word is functioning as subject complement because children and they are not two different persons. They are one and the same. So, here children is functioning as a subject complement in this sentence. Number three, I am an assistant teacher. In this sentence, the word I is a pronoun and it is used as a subject. An assistant teacher. Teacher is a noun. It is functioning as subject complement because teacher and I are not different person. They are one and the same. So here we learn noun can function as a subject complement. Subject complement is giving more information about the subject. Number five. Object complement. Object complement adds something in the meaning of indirect object. We know that there are two objects, direct object and indirect object. Indirect object is a noun or pronoun. Whenever pronoun comes as indirect object, it comes in objective case. And direct objects are the names of things, atom or objects. Let's see here how does the Noun function as objective complement. Noun can function as object complement in the sentence. Example, we have made Modi a leader. Here, Modi and leader are one and the same person. Just what is Modi? Modi is a leader. It means this noun is describing to the Modi or this indirect object. So, noun is functioning as an object complement in the sentence. Number 2, poverty made him a waiter. Him and a waiter, these are not two different persons. They are one and the same. The job of this object is a waiter. So, here this waiter noun is functioning as object complement. Number 6, nouns in opposition. Opposition means placing near. It is a noun simply used to describe noun subject. It means that noun in opposition is directly describing to the main subject. For example, Virat, our captain, made 50 runs. Virat is subject. This word is noun and captain, this word is also noun. But Virat and captain are not two different persons. But this word captain is giving more information about this subject. So, noun in opposition is also functioning as a noun. Number 2. Kabir, a great reformer, was a weaver. In this sentence, Kabir is a noun. It is proper noun. This noun is functioning as a subject. A great reformer. Reformer is also a noun. But this noun is giving additional information about Kabir. So, it is nouns in opposition. So, here we learn the usages of noun and functions of noun. Now, we will see the second parts of speech. Hi friends, good morning, namaskar. I am Tukaram Shivaji Admane. I work as an assistant teacher in Yogeshwari Nutan Vidyalaya Ambazogai. I welcome to learn the second part of parts of speech. Second parts of speech is pronoun. Pronoun means for a noun. A word that is used for a noun is called pronoun. The main use of pronoun is to avoid the repetition of noun or noun phrase in the sentence or paragraph. Before going to see the definitions of pronoun, let's see this example to understand what is pronoun better. Look at Madhuri, she is dancing. Geeta and Ganesh have come to see her dance. She is happy to see them. Madhuri is proper noun. She, this word is used to avoid the repetition of this noun. So, it is pronoun. Already we have seen pronoun means for a noun. Geeta and Ganesh, these two names are proper nouns. Her, this word is used to avoid the repetition of Madhuri, so it is pronoun. She is happy to see them. This is also pronoun. It is also used to avoid the repetition of Madhuri. Here we understood that what is pronoun? Pronoun is a word or pronouns are words which are used to avoid the repetition of noun. Now let's see some definition. Pronouns are words which can replace noun or noun phrase. Pronouns are words which can be used in the place of noun to avoid the repetition of noun. Second, pronoun is a word used in the place of noun or noun phrase. Third, a word that is used instead of a noun or noun phrase to avoid the repetition of noun or noun phrase is called a pronoun. Here we clearly understood that Pronoun is a word which is used in the place of noun to avoid its repetition. Let's see the types of pronouns. There are so many kinds of pronouns. Personal pronoun, possessive pronoun, demonstrative pronoun, relative pronoun, interrogative pronoun, emphatic pronoun, reflexive pronoun, indefinite pronoun, etc. Let's see some kinds of pronoun in detail. Number one, personal pronouns. Personal pronouns are used for the persons only. Personal pronouns have the same gender and number for which they are used. It means these pronouns are used just for the same person and same gender. These pronouns are also classified in three categories: first person pronoun, second person pronoun, third person pronoun. The first person pronouns are the speakers. Second person's pronouns are the listener or to whom they are speaking. And third person pronouns are the persons about whom they are speaking. First person pronouns, second person pronoun, and third person pronouns can be used as subject, object, and also possessive case. We have given here in details how to use them as a subject, object, and possessive as well as reflexive pronoun. Subjective pronouns: I, we, you, they, he, she, it. These pronouns are used as subject in the sentence, so they are called as subjective pronouns. I, singular; we, plural; you, singular and plural; they, plural; he, singular; she, singular; it, singular. Objective pronouns: me, us, you, them, him, her, it. These pronouns are used as an object in the sentence, so these are also called as objective pronouns. Next, possessive pronouns. Possessive pronoun shows the ownership of object or something. These pronouns are mine, ours, yours, theirs, his, her, its. For example, that book is mine. So mine shows the possession. Next, reflexive or emphatic pronouns. Reflexive or emphatic pronouns are made by suffixing self or selves at the end. Myself, ourselves, yourself, yourselves, themselves, himself, herself, itself. Kind second, relative pronouns. Example: this is a boy who works hard. In this sentence, boy is noun, and for this noun, this word who is used as pronoun. So this is a relative pronoun because it is used for the noun which was already used before. Second, these are the students whose exercises are done. In this sentence, student is noun. Whose? This is a pronoun because this word is used for students, so it is relative pronoun. Now see the definition of relative pronoun. Relative pronouns refer or relate to the sum nouns used before or earlier. It means that relative pronouns are the words which are used for the nouns which had already mentioned in the same sentence. Some more relative pronouns are who, whose, whom, what, that, whoever, whosoever, whichever, whatever, whomsoever, etc. Number three, demonstrative pronouns. Demonstrative pronouns are used to demonstrate or point out the objects or things around us. For example, this is my room, that is your class. this and that, these are singular pronouns, these and those are plural pronouns, these are demonstrative pronouns. Pronouns used to point out the objects are called demonstrative pronouns. These pronouns demonstrate or point out the object, and these pronouns are this, that, these, those. Number 4. Indefinite pronouns. Pronouns used in general to refer person or things are called indefinite person. Pronouns which are used in general for the person or things, they are not specially or specifically addressed or identified. So, these pronouns are called as indefinite pronouns. Indefinite pronouns are one, any, few, some, anybody, everybody, each, their, it, etc. These pronouns can be used in a general way to address anybody who is not special or who is not referred anywhere. For example, anybody can dance. Here the word anybody is indefinite pronoun because we don't know who is that anybody. Number 5. Interrogative pronouns. Interrogative pronouns are the interrogative words which can be used for asking questions. Pronouns used for asking questions are called interrogative pronouns. For example, who is there? What's the matter? These are interrogative pronouns because these are used to ask the question. More example of interrogative pronouns are who, whom, what, which, whoever, whatever, etc. Last type, negative pronouns. None, nobody, nothing are negative pronouns. These words are showing the negative sense in the sentence. For example, nobody was present for the meeting except chairperson and invited guests during the period of lockdown.